my answer to that was, how do you think we got these dogs that we have without that program going down the line? If we stop doing that, what you're suggesting, we will produce mongrels.
Ukoliko, moj odgovor na to je u stvari, šta mislite kako su nastali svi ovi dobri psi koje sada imamo, ukoliko prekinemo sa takvim programom proizvodi, nastavićemo da proizvodimo mešance, loše pse.
And by saying that, I mean the most important word in dog breeding is time. Once, I emphasize again, once we lose time, we've lost everything.
I opet naglašavam da je u stvari najvažniji tip psa.
It's the most important word, it's the most important thing that we must retain within us as breeders.
To je najbitnija reč, najbitnija stvar koju mi moramo zapamtimo kao i da održimo među sobom kao odgajivače.
If you lose type, you lose the breed.
Ukoliko izgubite tip, izgubili ste rasu.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for listening, and if there's any questions you would like to ask me, I'm all ears. Oh, and it must be questions from these guys
yes,
here.
Yes,
they were
yes.
doing plenty of listening. Yeah. Let's hear the questions.
How many times you inbreed the mother, the son, father, the daughter? How many times?
That's strong line breeding. Good. That's good strong line breeding. It doesn't make any difference how many times. Get as many as you want.
To je odličan način uzgajanja, nije uopšte bitno po kojoj
liniji. Pitao je koliko je puta on to koristio.
How many times you do this?
How many times have I done this? Maybe 40, 50 times.
Yeah. Mnogo puta.
Yes. But using good animals, that's important. And using what I spoke about with the anchor. Always make sure the anchor is there.
Koristio sam dobre životinje svaki put i svaki put sam se trudio da tu bude prisutan taj pas koji je temelj čitavog odgoja.
As the line goes on, you find another anchor. Because that anchor, the weakness, the dilute of the first anchor is the one. So the further you go into the pedigree, you have got then to find another anchor or two anchors if possible.
I kako nastavite s odgajivanjem, tako nastavite da pronalazite novog psa koji će biti temelj date linije, pogotovo da vam nestane onaj prethodni pas.
Koliko puta bi se pojavio isti pas u jednom rodu?
Može samo se
sve pojaviti.
Redom.
Zaprstajem, ja sam Milo Čirović, odgajivač drugo godina američkih statnosti terijera, odgajivač sam Lindo Prince iz Srbije i Beograda.
Prvo pitanje, prilikom razgovora sa ljudima koji se bave uzgojem i davanja saveta sa strane gospodina, da li se desilo nekada da je nešto zadržao za sebe kao tajnu, da nije preneo nikim drugom, već samo za sebe to podrži? Mm-hmm. To je jedno pitanje.
He has three questions for you. The first one is when you talk to people and organize people, have there been times that you kept some secrets for yourself or you told them everything you knew when people ask you for advice?
Of course I never. Of course I didn't tell him everything.
Of course.
Now I'm an older man and I haven't but a lot of years to live. I can spill the beans.
Dobro, drugo pitanje moje je,
ja izlažem svoje pse svugde po Evropi na najvećim izložbama. I u zadnjih par godina srećem se u ringu sa sudijama koje često koriste termin moderato taj, odnosno moderan tip. Ja u standardu nigde nisam pročitao da ima moderan tip i stari tip. Pa me interesuje šta gospodin misli o tome.
Moderato?
Je moderan tip, razumete, šta to znači moderan tip, a šta znači zastareo tip? Ja u standardu se nisam sreo sa takvim tumačenjem nigde. Pa me interesuje šta gospodin misli o tome.
So he asked what you think about that, and what is that modern life, and what is the old or out-of-date style dog? Is that something he never seen that in the standard race?
There's nothing in the standard saying that that's the modern type or that's the old type. That's a personal opinion of the judge who's judging for the breed of the day.
Kaže da ste upravo ne postoji ništa u standardu, to je samo lično mišljenje sudije koji su...
I treće pitanje vezano za pedigre. Znači, interesuje me šta gospodin misli o sledećem. Vrednost jednog psa, da li se meri njegovim rezultatima koje on ostvari na najvećim izložbama u jednom periodu od nekoliko godina i u priplodu, ako da, nekoliko takođe vrhunskih pasa koji u jednom kontinuitetu postižu izuzetno dobre zapažene rezultate ili možda nečim drugim?
Mislim da je vrednost.
Vrednost psa. Znači, da li se meri rezultatima koje taj pas postigne na najvećim izložbama, na prestižnim izložbama, ali u nizu od nekoliko godina, ne na jednoj, da zavisno da nema.
Ili po
fiktivnih igrača. Znači, na nekoliko izložbi, nekoliko godina, i potomstvo koje ostavi za sebe da izuzetno velike šampione koji takođe pobeđuju u nizu od par godina ili su u samom vrhu na tim izložbama.
Da li dobar pedigre što imaš šampione ili parci koji daje šampione?
Čovjek
ne
znaš što da
pita. Ne znaš što sam to.
Gospodje, što vi ne prelovite? Vi smo upućeni za to, možete
i da... Da li ste htjeli za
mi?
Give him the floor. He's asking the question.
Ne, ja bih kad dobro prelovite, čovjek ne razumije.
It's important, in my opinion, in my professional opinion, the pedigree, and it's only, I don't know who's winning, who's not, who's winning, but generally speaking, the pedigree breeds on. A dog who is a flash in the pan dog, even if he produces stuff, look at his offspring in 10 years' time. Are they going to be good? The dog with the pedigree, dogs will be good.
A ne znam, ali nisam skorila
prije. Odgovor je, dakle, da vam shvatate ipak pedigre važniji. Znači, bez obzira koliko imate psa koji je briljantan i koji izgledi sada, trenutno proizvodi...
Na duže stavu.
Samo sekund. Koji sada trenutno proizvodi dobre pse, koji su takođe šampioni, prvo verovatno da za 10 godina njegovi potomci neće proizvoditi šampione, da vam shvatate pedigre.
Odlično, ja sada imam završno pitanje, ako dozvolite. Sada, pedigre, ako gledamo pedigre, pa imamo u prvoj generaciji, recimo, evropskog svetskog šampiona, interšampiona, pa imamo u drugoj generaciji, evropskog svetskog, pa imamo u pet generacija, evropske svetske šampione i interšampione. da li je to merilo vrednosti dobrog pedigreja ili je dobar pedigre kad u tom pedigreju imamo pse u nekoj određenoj liniji, ali tu nema ni jednog evropskog, ni jednog svjetskog šampiona i veoma malo interšampiona. Da li ste me razumeli?
Mislim da je the question is whether the name of the measure is the pedigree is that, for example, in five generations, you have dogs where in every generation you have a European champion, international champion, super champion, and each generation you have it, or where you have longer line of good pedigree dogs, but with no such.
Well, I can answer that in one question. If you have a very prominent person who's showing that line of his dog and his dogs, 9 times out of 10 in Europe, the all-rounder looks at him. He knows that that dog is by his dog. He puts that up because he wants to play safe. And this is what happens. And yes, it's a very easy thing in Europe to make an international challenge. It's not a hard thing, but it's a hard thing, and it's an easy thing in Europe to produce champion after champion after champion. That's easy. It's not a difficult thing to do. If you've got a good dog, you can produce a good champion. But for a pedigree to continuously carry on, the secret of the pedigree, as I've explained, is the anchor. The anchor has got to produce an anchor, and that anchor has got to produce another anchor, but it's down to the talent of the pedigree reader to pick that anchor out and say, that's the anchor dog. It doesn't have to be the best dog they've ever bred, but they know that that's where the success is coming from, that anchor dog, and that makes it pedigree.
On smatra da nije tako teško proizvoditi pse šampione iz generacije u generaciju, potrebno je imati naravno jako dobro psa, ali dalje stoji za toga da je pedigre bitniji i to u sistemu pasa koji su temelj nastavka i takav jedan pas proizvodi drugog psa sa generacijama i sam taj pas koji nosi tu ovu genetiku koji proizvodi dalje
You may also get a person who has the financial position to attend every single show. And I've been in the dog game long enough, I've been a handler, I know what happens with handlers. I know in England we don't do it now because we're not allowed. But here in Europe, I've seen as a judge, I've seen handlers coming into the same hotel and staying in the same hotel as me, and I'm the person who's judging their breed. Now, in England or in the UK, that wouldn't be allowed. They wouldn't allow that. So what happens is you get the individual person who's got plenty of money, who has a decent dog, but the secret is how many times he may produce another international champion or she, another one, but have they produced the champions, or is it from another line that he's took in and made it up to another international champion? Or is it from the same line? Or is it from the success of the person attending every single show and has the clout to sit at the table with the judge and have a meal and so forth? There's the difference.
Postoje ljudi koji su u stanju da isprate svaku izložbu i da vode pse na svaku izložbu. Također ono što primetio u Evropi jeste da recimo handleri odsedaju istim kriterijima sa sudijama, u Engleskoj je to apsolutno nemoguće. Također postoji veza se takva jedna individua, takva jedna osoba koja je finansijski potrebna da izvodi pse na svaku izložbu, je također u situaciji da ruča večera sa sudijama i to se stvaraju.
Ništa, ja bih se zahvalio gospodinu na odgovorima i posle ovih odgovora imam još jedno ubeđenje da još više verujem u ono što sam do sada radio. Hvala.
Što me zanima sad, da sam ja njega dobro razumio.
Speak in English before you can.
Sorry, I know, understand, but who is very important? You have one dog is very good reproductor. The son of him is very good reproductor. This is very important.
Yes.
This is the.
It doesn't have to be a slang.
This is this is. Can you have line of good reproducers?
Okay.
I,
yes.
I very. Who is very important for me? Who? Pita ga šta je za njega dobar kad igra? To sam ja teo isto da pitam.
Da li, šta je dobar kad igra?
Šta je u stvari dobar kad igra? Da li su to...
Pravi anatomski pse.
Da li je dobar kad igra, znači psi koji daju dobre pse, uh-huh. ili kad igra je dobar samo što su šampioni?
He's asking this question. What exactly a good pedigree for you is? And again, rather, this is maybe similar question. You can say that a good pedigree dog is...
Mr. Dimon, now you look pedigree. You look pedigree. Team, it's very good pedigree. Why you think it's good pedigree?
Because it's an anchor dog there.
You know kids, this dog
very good. Yes, absolutely.
This is question. People coming and looking. Who is international champion? Sport champion, okay. I have respect for this dog, sport champion. It's a very good reproductor.
Yeah.
This is okay, but you know, for international champion here, you I need you fourth cut. That international is very easy, but very good reproductor is very important. Second question, I have fourth question for you. Second question, I'm very interested for bias. Bias. Sorry, I'm not за zagriz. To me jako zanima.
He's very interested in the type of the bite.
Bite for this for three for kaže za te tri rase. Ovde jako imam problema s udesom. Znači ne mogu da skontaju kako se šta se gleda kod bull terrier, šta se gleda kod američkog staffordskog terriera i od znači staffordskog bull terriera i koliko ih ima. Znači recimo to, znači za zagriz.
He's basically interested in the types of bites.
Bites.
Because he believes judges here are not
don't have idea.
They don't have any idea on what
they have
judge,
no idea.
They mix.
They have no idea. They're fools.
No,
they're absolute fools, and I'm not disrespecting them. They're fools. I'll give you a perfect example. Perfect example. I was judging in Sweden with two German judges. Nothing to do with the German people here, but I was judging with two old German guys. I'm a bull terrier breeder, so we start talking about.
It's English. You have
Deutschland school? No, wait a minute. Let me finish what I'm saying.
Sorry.
Let me finish. And I said to these guys, here's an example. Supposing, I think we spoke about this before, the bull terrier comes into the ring. It's the best bull terrier you've ever seen in your life. The hair is standing up on the back of your neck. It's so good. Even as an all-rounder, you can see this is a great dog. I said, what would you do if that dog had a P1 missing? Out! I said, excuse me ladies, my exact words to him were, you're fucking crazy, man. And the man was crazy, absolute crazy. Because this dog had a P1 missing, this is the greatest bull terrier he's ever seen, he went out. I said, for what reason? Give me a reason why you say this. He said, if it was a female, it couldn't sever the umbilical cord. I said, don't talk stupid. If a boxer, if a bulldog, if a bull mastiff can sever it, who's undershot? Why would a bull terrier without a P1 missing, that's the greatest dog you've ever seen, not be able to do that? You're stupid, man. You have lost a great dog to the breed. And that is an anchor dog, because that was the great dog. Even with that one little misdemeanor in Europe, in England, we don't even count teeth. You could have been missing a P1, you could be missing a P4. You ask 90% of the judges in England, what's a P1 and a P4? They will think you're talking about a program and you fill in your tax. It's so stupid. It's absolutely stupid. Because what happens then is you have lost a great stallion or a great producer or a great anchor dog to the breed because of one stupid P2 or P1 or P1 is missing. Second question.
Do recimo u odnosu na starost psa, do koje on granice da li pas, da li može, znači da li ovaj prolazi još kod njega, znači ovaj klešta što zeba, zubalo, ako pa su to, znači zanima me šta on kad gleda kog psa, do koje granice on još kod njega, znači zanima me, razumeš me šta će?
Do koje granice?
Da li gleda onda su kako je pas stari?
Ja nemo gleda razumeš šta.
Kada drži kola?
Kada drži kola?
When you judge the quality of bites, do you pay attention or when the bite is there, pay attention to the bad things in that bite? Depending on the age of the dog or what is your limit to allow the dog
the to pass? I look at the dog, the overall dog. If, for example, a second rate dog has an incorrect bite and it's second rate, you're out. Your number's up, you're out. If it's a second rate dog, real second rate dog, but if it's a good dog and you can see the strong virtues, and when you judge as a judge, you must judge to virtues. So if a dog is a very, very good dog and it has a slightly wrong mouth, I never seen that mouth. I looked at the overall dog. I looked at everything in the dog. And that's the important thing.
Dakle, čovjek kaže da on u stvari gleda celog psa. Opet, celog psa. Ukoliko je taj pas drugorazredni, ima problematično zubalo, on će ga diskvalifikovati. Ukoliko vidi vrhunskog psa, gleda celog psa, vidi u njemu dobrog primjerka, rase, onda neće. Znači, bitan mu je celokupan pas, neke mane mogu da se prevaziđu, može da se ne vidi to, recimo, inkorektno zubalo, ukoliko je taj pas inače izuzetno kvalitetan.
I have been judging now for 35 years, 46 years altogether I've been feeding dogs. I've been judging as an international judge for 35 years. I was one of the youngest ever international judges to come out of the UK at that time. And I can honestly say to you, I have never ever pulled a stroke in any way towards an exhibitor, because you can drink with me all night till 3 a.m, but the next day, aha, there's another hat goes on. I'm Danny the judge. But when I come out the ring, let's go and have a drink. And that, and concentration. Concentration as a judge is vitally important. I have seen far too many judges losing concentration. I give you an example. I judged in South Africa 4 times. The very first time I judged in South Africa, very first time. The secretary came to me before I started judging and said, "Mr. Gilmer, we have a problem." I said, "What's the problem?" He said, "We have 250 samples of no merit here today." There's a problem. And I laughed. I said, "Can I tell you, 6 weeks ago I judged 500 staffers of rural areas in one day." So, but the secret of that is concentration. Concentrate. That guy who's coming into the ring, or woman who's coming into the ring that dog, has paid their money for you to go over that dog. So you must give them their money. This matter how many of them. Give them all and judge them honestly. Stand up and get counted.
Okay, dakle, ono što je govorio o početku jeste da on može da večera sa vama, da pije sa vama, da bude dobro sa vama, nego sa vama kao vama, nego kao sa uzgajivačima. Međutim, on kada uđe u ring, on tu postaje sudija koji gleda u tom momentu samo psa, a ne vlasnika.
Ja bih imao dva pitanja po ovom krštanju, pa lakše vas pokažem. Gospodine, pošto je radio to ministro parenje, to krštanje, da vam kaže njegovo iskustvo. Koja varijanta mu se najbolje pokazala? Primjer 2-2, 3-2, 2-3 ili 4-2 i tako dalje. To je prvo pitanje.
Yes,
the
this. Could you show me? Da mi pokažeš.
Otac na...
Pitanje, koliko
puta se... Prva generacija, druga, treća.
Koja je ja što najbolje? Da li palimo 2-2? Da li tu previše blizu? Da li palimo 3-2?
Da li 2-3-2?
The likeness, the likeness, the likeness to each other. They must look like each other.
They must,
more of these,
is it better whether they're like mother?
The two puppies must look like each other. Because they have taken everyone, they have taken 50-50 from each animal. Remember, these animals are inbred, they're inbred to the younger dog.
Okay. And the relationship between them,
so you don't look to the bench, you look to the good bench line. It's important.
Yeah,
brother and sister.
Yeah.
If you have six puppies, if the two puppies could look most like each other.
Znači, da nema pravila, znači da nije bitno kojom linijom se ide, bitno je da dva psa koja izaberete liče da su slične gradijenti, jedno da su slični, bukvalno slični jedan drugo. Znači nije bitno koju liniju ćete graditi.
Kad se dobije znači krajnji cilj, znači dobije se vrhunska jedinka. Koliko puta se taj anket, znači to siro pojavljuje u jednom rodovniku, po ocu, po majci, i ako može gospodin da nam kaže iz iskustva, neki njegov šampion najbolji, koliko puta i na kojim mjestima da nam pokaže se pojavljuje taj jedan isti pas.
To je telo, to sam po moj drugo pitanje.
His grandmother, his father had produced six champions, but his father wasn't the anchor. His father's mother was the anchor, because when you look at that bitch, the name of that bitch, and the champions had come that way and that way, the six champions had come from her son, but 10 champions had come that way. So it wasn't the son who was the anchor, although he had produced six champions. It was his mother, who was a champion bitch. And she produced champion after champion after champion, both daughters and sons and granddaughters. So it wasn't the dog with the six champions who was the father of my dog, who was the father of 12 champions. It was...
Okay. Dakle, on je imao psa šampiona, njegov otac je proizveo, otac tog njegovog psa je proizveo 6 šampiona, taj njegov pas je proizveo 12 šampiona, ali nije on ni njegov otac bio taj pas temelj, nego je to...